very warm welcome to you. We're in Austria for the opening round of the 2013 FIA European Rally Championship. It's the Jana getting us underway. And what a place to be. Based in Freistadt in Upper Austria, the rally's smooth and undulating asphalt stages coated in snow and ice. And when the ERC was last in town in January 2012, it was that way. And indeed, the weather forecast predicting exactly the same. Some familiar names to you and maybe some new ones along the way. Some to conjure with. Raymond Baumschlager as well, the Austrian champion this year. So is the champion of the Czech Republic, Jan Kopecký, you've met before. And Kajan Kajetanovic, Romania.
This year it will be very difficult rally because the conditions are crazy, I have to say. On few stages you can find the ice, on few stages you can find the snow. And the conditions has been changing all the time, as you can see also now. And no one can tell you now what is going to be tomorrow. So the tire choice will be very important for everyone. But anyway, this rally is really beautiful because the stages are very fast and fluent, and they are really nice to watch for the spectators.
Yes, I know. Kajetanovic is the Polish champion. Look at this absolutely dramatic backdrop. It's a beautiful part of the world. More than 60 crews have entered this wonderful international event, featuring 18 special stages over a competitive distance of 248.46 kilometres. A further 33 crews set to tackle the national level rallies. Honours in the Austrian, the Czech championships up for grabs as well. So an awful lot at stake. So 10 special stages for leg one of the rally around Freistadt. Weather conditions, unpredictable. Road conditions, unpredictable. Tyre choice, well, unpredictable. Early morning in Freistadt, temperatures just around about freezing. All drivers living in the service area, essentially, for the first three stages of the morning. Yes, first stage wet, second stage half snow at this time, and half ice for the final one. Talks of full snow as well. Very tricky tyre choice then. It's basically the best compromise between the tyres, and Jan Kopecký leaving service with wide snow tyres with studs. Baumschlager going for narrow snow tyres with studs. Anyone's guess then? Pirbach, 18.99 kilometres at just after 20 past 8, local time in the morning, and plenty have been out here for their knackwurst and a bit of glue wine, I'll be bound, just to get everything settled. So what about that stage? First stage of the day, two passes indeed of leg one. Snow on the roads with air temperature around about 6 Celsius on the rise then. Tyre choice crucial as it was in stage two, as you will see. Jan Kopecký first on the roads, making a safe choice. Four wide studded tyres, and it proved to be the best choice as he set the fastest time of 13.08.7 for the 18.99 kilometres of the stage. So, good start.
The stage is almost wet, but of course you can find some icy patches which are very dangerous because there is no grip at all, suddenly, but luckily we have everything in the notes. We have white tires, so we need to survive now, next two stages.
Second on the road, Brian Bouffier made the same tyre choice as Kopecký, second fastest with his Peugeot. I see the 207 flying again, 4.7 behind Kopecký by the end of this run. Bouffier, well, he's used to strange weather conditions, of course, winner of the Monte Carlo in the past. Not quite those kind of conditions just for now, but tricky nonetheless under the leaden skies and visibility quite low. We're not talking fog, we're talking about shadowing. Hard to read, sort of flat light, if you will. Still, good opener for Bouffier.
I'd say it's very hot, so it's not easy to see the ice. And the ice, when it's hot, doesn't have a good grip. But anyway, happy to be here. And the time is not so bad compared to Jan, so we have to continue like this.
Time for an old favourite. Got himself a Peugeot 207. Well, in Romania, as you probably know. Third on the road, Francois Delacour. Made a more risky tyre choice always seems to do that, doesn't he? Yes. Mixing it up. Two studded tyres, two snow tyres without studs, mounted in cross formation. Studs on the front left and right rear, two spares in the boot. Unfortunately, it doesn't pay off, and he lost 21.9 seconds on Kubecki in the opening stage. Great to see that man's face. And indeed, all the grimaces therein. Well, we'll have a clear view of the importance of tyre choice here. If we use the simulcam system between Kubecki and Delacour right now, tyres on Kubecki, Skoda, four studded tyres, remember. Delacour, now let's just see how it all works out. Well, looking again at the road section, it's easy to understand that after 19 kilometres, the difference is almost 22 seconds. More than a second per kilometre. Clearly, it's grip out of the corners. That's vital. Let's speak to Francois.
I think it was a mistake, but we will see on the next stage because I have four studs for the next stage.
There you go. He's going to swap them over. Raymond Baumschlanger of Austria. Yes, even worse for him, I'm afraid. Decided to use narrow studded snow tyres instead of the wider ones used by the Michelin drivers. Aboard his Skoda Fabia, it was a bit of a handful. At the end of the gap, Kopecky and he were separated by 57.2 seconds. Bad start for the local hero. There's still two stages to go. With full snow and ice predicted, it could change.
A wrong tyre choice, definitely. We were expecting much, much more ice. And we are the only one at the front with narrow ones. But the next two stages will be more snow.
There you go. That's exactly what he's hoping for. Vaclav Pesch. Up next, eighth on the road. Yes, Pesch also making what could be described as a safe choice, as Kubecki, Bouffier, Valasek and Solovov. Wide studded tyres from Michelin. And he sets the third fastest time with a 12.6 deficit on Kubecki. Great to see the Mini in action. Subaru Impreza of Kajetan Kajetanovic of Poland, 12th on the road and finishes in the top of the production cars standing. Six fastest on the stage as well, losing only 25.6 to the leader Kopecky. Also wide studded tyres. Looks kind of grisly out there, doesn't it? Kubecki then well and truly in control early on. Bouffier 4.7 seconds adrift. Pesch going well with the Mini Cooper 12.6 behind. Valasek and Delacour making up the top five. Kajetanovic ruining his choices. Tarabus as well, keeping everyone honest. But Baumschlanger could have done better. 57.2 down, not good. We'll see how the recovery begins after this. Welcome back. Liebenau beckoning, 10.22 kilometres in total, just after 24 or 25 minutes past nine local time. And yes, after the opener, it's time to regather yourselves. I think road conditions much more tricky, as you can see. The fog coming down, starting to get wet, icy in places, snow in some parts. Read that. Jan Kubecki first on the road, wide studded tyres, as you know, car sliding around quite a bit. Lost precious seconds out there. 15th fastest only, Brian Bouffier. Well, it was a rough stage for the Frenchman. Was surprised by the icy patches. Drove, I think, safely, really. 30th on the timing sheets through here. Dropping to fifth, losing his second place to Vaclav Pesch. François Delacour, rough stage as well, had some off-road moments. Only 7.7 down on Kopecky though in that stage, remaining in third place. Baumschlanger. Well, after his outrageously poor opening stage, he was determined to do something. Disastrous tyre choice. Turned out to be the best tyre choice, though. Narrow studded tyres, he was rocking. Look at that. Quickest time, 27.5 seconds faster than Kopecky. You see how fortunes can swing one way and then the next. This is Beppo Harasch and his Mitsubishi Lancer. Narrow studded tyres as well. Second quickest. What about that? Impressive result from the Production Car Cup. 1.7 seconds slower than Baumschlanger. Proving that tyre choice really is essential, but of course you can't just swap them and change them that often. Your morning choices, you have to live with them. St. Oswald, 8.68 kilometres, a short one then, just after 10 o'clock local time. And Vaclav Pesch on board his Mini. Little drama, I'm afraid, had a little off-road. It's nearly 10 seconds because of this. Not too bad then, but dropped a third overall. Short stage this one, but snow and ice reported throughout, and well, they were kind of finding it. As you can see, it's the sort of pace that you think you could manage yourself. Let me tell you otherwise. Raimund Baumschlanger, fourth quickest, had a near off. It's almost white out, as you can see, in the flat light. Like in stage two, good tyre choice on this ice-coated section, narrow studded tyres. And it worked out well for Baumschlanger. Moved from fourth to second overall, proving that you can find your way back in such mixed conditions. Now just 2.3 seconds off the leader, Jan Kopecky. Car wailing in submission, as you can hear. Jaroslav Orzak, Czech Republic, and his Mitsubishi Lancer. Just look how skinny those wheels look. Quickest time in the production car. Moved from 16th to 8th overall. That is impressive. Sergei then making up the top five here with Kopecky still out there. But Baumschlanger, what a change of fortune. Just 2.3 seconds now separating him and our leader. After three tricky stages, all the drivers back in Friedstadt for a 20-minute service. Jan Kopecky still leading the rally, as you've seen. Rarely smiles, but he looks all right.
There was a lot of soft snow and ice, which was melting down. And when you came to the slush, you know, the tires were not working at all, so you didn't have any grip. But finally, we are here. We are on the first place, so I think the tire choice was good.
There you go, serious business. And after three stages, Delacour, 2 seconds behind another French driver, Brian Bouffier. There you go.
The same spirit. You have always to drive with a compromise, and it's difficult.
There you go. But remember his fantastic run a couple of years ago in the Monte Carlo.
Especially in stage three, I was pushing in the beginning and it worked well. But then I made a big mistake and nearly went off. Oh, I was off, yeah. But I nearly hit some concrete. And then I slow it down a little bit because I guess it will be so difficult this night with the fog in the mountains, and I think there will be big time jumps like in the first stage.
Baumschlanger Klanger then did go off, you'll forgive me, he will. Second loop then, the stage, three on the day, three stages all together through various degrees of difficulty, as you can see, and indeed grip levels. Brian Bouffier on wide with studs. Two spares in the boot, quickest time on stage four and second quickest at stage five. He was fastest on six and fifth overall after stage six, 4.6 seconds behind Horash. Baumschlanger. Wide with studs, two spares in the boots. Everyone just carrying the maximum here. Fourth quickest on stage five and took the lead. Now just 3.4 seconds ahead of Kopecky overall. Seventh quickest on stage six.